Hello and welcome to The Loop. From the State Emergency Operations Center, I'm Matt Bruning.
And in Shelby County, I'm Renata Ford. Ohio is one of the states to experience the total solar eclipse. Here in District 7, we had some of the longest amount of totality in the state. Lauren Bryson is here to tell us more.
That's right, Renee. Sydney, Ohio was among a few of the cities that experienced nearly 4 minutes of totality. Our team here in District 7 began the discussion of the eclipse a few years ago. As we prepared for this day, we worked closely with local and state partners like county EMAs and the Ohio State Highway Patrol. Key staff members manned the D7 EOC starting early in the morning, keeping a close eye on traffic as the day progressed. Our incredible county and facility crews were staged at critically identified locations, ready to assist as the totality line passed through the center of our district. After the eclipse, we saw increased traffic as viewers began their departure. We hope that everyone enjoyed this historic event and appreciate all those who worked to help keep Ohioans and our visitors safe.
Well, thanks a lot, Lauren. Back here at the EOC, we were keeping an eye on the situation around the state. We saw some of the heaviest traffic in Northwest Ohio, where the clouds seem to clear the most.
This is the very first time and probably the last seeing that the next one won't be until 2099. But yeah, I'm totally excited.
One of the largest cities in the path of totality was Cleveland.
Traffic in Northeast Ohio moved very smoothly before, during, and after complete totality. We've seen no major backups or delays. In locations where we don't have good traffic camera coverage, we've utilized our drone operator to help us monitor traffic. Reporting for The Loop in Lorain County, I'm Amanda McFarland.
Thank you to all the ODOT crews, law enforcement, first responders, emergency management, and thousands of others who helped everyone coming to watch this once-in-a-lifetime event.
Well, the state EOC has also been keeping a close eye on flooding since last week. We saw a lot of flooding and slips in eastern and southeastern Ohio. High water even threatened I-70 near Buckeye Lake in Licking County, but it didn't get high enough to actually impact the interstate. The Ohio River came out of its banks, creating some significant flooding issues in places like Marietta.
Of course, the work really just begins for our crews. Once that high water does go down, we're going to be busy cleaning up debris from our roadways, clearing ditches, also cleaning out culverts that have been backed up due to all this water.
It's a good time to remind you to never drive around barricades or into high water like this guy on the south side of Columbus. Now, thankfully, he was able to walk out to dry land where Franklin County Sheriff's deputies met him with a citation.
This week also included the Civil Rights Transportation Symposium. This year's theme was moving beyond what is now, fostering accessibility, equality, and inclusion in Ohio's transportation industry. The goal is to ensure that opportunities are available to everyone when it comes to working to build and maintain our transportation infrastructure in Ohio.
The event also included an awards ceremony. Congratulations to all the winners.
Next week is construction kickoff in Ohio and National Work Zone Awareness Week, a time to remind you to be extra alert in those work zones.
Get more ODOT news online at transportation.ohio.gov. Follow us on social media and keep sending those great story ideas and feedback to loop@dot.ohio.gov.
And now you're in the loop. Woo!